What's good,
yo,
my boy?
What's poppin'?
That's on the neighborhood, cuz.
Say word.
What up?
Yo, what's poppin' with y'all lashy asses? Nico in the building making aunties bat them lashes. Melly with the jelly making brothers do a double take. Got the hash on deck to be way more than half-baked. Love is at war, hit the general, yeah, yeah, yo. Listen to the wisdom, how your love life like, ayo. All this in the hour, it'll never be a bore. So welcome everybody, this is Ethnic Ish and More.
Yo, what's poppin', cuz? Yeah, you know, still banging Ducky 12 and 19, the only season I don't use. But nigga, have you heard Ethnic Ish and More, cuz? They got more shit on there, cuz. They doing past the political shit, nigga. They doing relationship shit. Like, Mark girl even mad at me for cheating no more, yo. Shout out to yeah, yo. Ayo, nigga, have you seen Melly Mel's IG? Cuz on neighborhood, she gotta be jelly, cuz jam don't shake like that. And she got the hash on lock, nigga. They on there for an hour, cuz. You better tune in, check that shit out on neighborhood, cuz.
up in his cash, yeah. His last head, yeah. Holds fire with your passion, yeah. They mad, yeah. You can ride in the jag, yeah. With that, yeah. You can smoke up by your bag, yeah. A grass, yeah. Got money, I can fast, yeah. And trash, yeah. I'm a big time a nigga, yeah. Pull a trigger, yeah. I play a hater flipper, yeah. Great filler, yeah. I'm like slinging wood, yeah. Out the hood, yeah. Let it be understood, yeah. It's all good, yeah. Got a nigga screaming large, yeah. On the hard, yeah. A smooth, yeah. A broad, yeah. I'm on the drug, yeah. I'm gonna do a trick, yeah. On the dick, yeah. Claiming you wanna bitch, yeah. That ain't shit, yeah. The nigga with the money, yeah. Throwing that money, yeah. Got birds and the money, yeah. About a hundred, yeah. Girl, you look good. Want you back that ass up. You's a fine motherfucker. Want you back that ass up. Only get daddy when you back that ass up. Oh, who is you playing with? Back that ass up. Girl, you look good. Want you back that
C-section, scripping bitches. Jared like him with the bullet wounds and ratchet. Me personally, I'd rather just take out 100 ones and have my girl shake her booty. Cause I'd rather know where my money went to.
Well, she can't shake it.
She can move that motherfucker. We can look tutorials. Tutorials, goddamn it. We go YouTube, some videos.
Oh my god. You go
with, baby, you gonna have to make that motherfucker move with a dude. Shout out to my nigga DC in the building. Hey y'all. I done gave my claps, but I forgot to give you a couple turn-ups. So I gave him in a row a turn-up. Hopefully, y'all was already turned up, especially if you was listening to them first two songs. I mean, the first one really ain't going to make you twerk. I don't know why I wanted to play Missy Elliott's Soccer to Me. I was literally sitting at the computer. I was typing. I was just like, oh, ah. I was like, I heard that motherfucker in a minute. Then I went on this whole 90s rap spiel, except for one song, because yo, it's always a nigga that don't be on time that requests music. So. That's my nigga, though. It's been my nigga since 09. Shout out to Yayo LaFleur. Shout out to Melanie Marie. They should be in the building. Sooner than later, we're going to hope. But y'all, we're back on another episode of Ethnic Ish and More. Episode number 50. 5-0, y'all. We've been doing this shit. Technically, I'm on episode number 60. If I use my 10 episodes from my pilot season. I did 10 episodes before I did it like this.
Well, you should count those.
Yeah, but the only reason I don't, because I call it like my pilot season. It wasn't the podcast yet. So I counted based off of the recordings. So 50 weeks straight, like the mailman, rain, sleet, or snow, I've been in this hole. I'll make sure I come and give y'all at least a decent show for it. At first, it was an hour. I got to add a little 30 more minutes to y'all niggas because I felt like an hour wasn't enough, including all the music we was playing. And we had more to say at times, which luckily I didn't really ramp up the music or change the amount. I just got to have more words to it because I'll be having a lot to say. Like, you'd be surprised how fast an hour go by.
Yeah.
Most people can't talk for an hour. I've done episodes where it's just me here. I'm like, damn.
And you're trying to figure out what to say.
But for some reason, I could just keep going. Yeah. That's the purpose, y'all. If you want to do a podcast, this is the beauty of it. Write your shit down. A show of any sort. I executive produce this motherfucker. I literally type this shit up week in and week out. Usually, I don't do that motherfucker till the day before.
Or the morning. But at least you get done.
It ain't because I kind of wait. Not because I am a procrastinator by nature. Like, I've been doing that my entire life. But usually when you put it that last moment pressure, you tend to get your best work that you want done. When it's under pressure, I'm like, shit, I got to have this done. And then it'd be so much stuff that go on throughout a week. If I wrote it like the day after the episode, I'd be sitting up here doing edits through the whole time. I'm like, nigga, I could have just wrote that shit out on Tuesday and just collected all the information. I'll be storing it up here for the most part. Then it's just putting it on paper.
Yeah.
And I got a template, so I'll just go through that motherfucker, just fill in the blanks. And it's like, nigga, a little bit of time around this biatch. So, y'all heard them two songs, Sock It To Me and Back That Ass Up. I hope a couple of y'all threw your backs out at the crib. Throw it out for you, nigga. Shout out to my nigga Nina in the motherfucking building, LU, as always. I want to welcome y'all ashy asses back for another week. For some reason, y'all have been sticking with me 50 straight weeks, y'all listen. I don't know why, but I greatly appreciate it. I probably would have been cutting my ass off because I'd be tired of hearing me sometimes too. But if you like it, I love it, goddammit. So we're going to keep doing that. Shout out to My City, My Music. Just to kick it in the motherfucking building as usual. That's the man and playing in the back. Shout out to Tweezy the Dime. Make sure y'all catch us on MyCityMyMusic.com, EthnicIshAndMore.com. You can go to BudTalkSTL/EthnicIshAndMore. Where else? You can listen to us on Spreaker, which is our main platform. If you don't like watching and listening live, we do have I'm on 22 plus streaming platforms. So you can listen, just type in Ethnic Ish and More on your leisure, Apple Podcast, Spotify, iHeart. As soon as I end the episode, it uploads to all of that. And I gave y'all more description work now. So when you want to find info about the people I'm talking to, you can literally look on there and click on the links that clickable. Luckily for the first two people this year, this is when I started doing that. I kept saying I would do it. I was really horrible about it because it was extra work.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm doing better for myself. So shout out to the first two people that get the benefit from this, because I'll be writing like straight mini blogs about y'all. Like, and they be coming, I'll be like, damn, nigga, you can put some words together. Because I did horrible in English, so I definitely thought my sentence structure was going to be nigga, commas was going to be everywhere and shit. That's like, well, I'm going to watch this nigga show. Nick can't even type right. But I'm getting it together, y'all. Shout out to the people that proofread my shit, which is nobody. But the spell check on the computer. Shout out to Google Documents. And shout out to our wonderful sponsors, Cash App. And like I say every week, Jack Dorsey, I'm trying to get my student loans paid, bro. You don't have to give me the money outright, but you could teach me the motherfucking game. Goes, but if you prefer to just give me the money outright, you know, use me as one of your little black charity tokens. Let me help this brother out. Not only is he an employee of me, we do sponsor him. Who am I to tell you what to do with your money, my brother? So you can slack me. I'll slack you. You got all my info in your database at work. Come find a real nigga. We could chop it up. We could politic. We can make some shit shake in the black community. Or just for me. I mean, I'll be trying to help niggas out too. It got to start with me first. Then I can help out the other folks underneath that. And y'all, since we're on episode 50, I started something new I said I'd do last week because Melanie was looking up numbers because we kept talking about the number five. So, you know, she get deep into her numbers. So now I do the numerology corner. And I'm going to do it for every number for the episode. So what I found about the number 50, it says the numerology number 50 expresses its sense of personal freedom. Expression of personal freedom for 50 is the pursuit of whatever may be of interest at the moment it becomes of interest without resistance from its inner self or from others. The number 50 is witty. I like that, y'all. So if you got some shit you're trying to do in your life, you got a little random thing your interest spark, do that shit. Don't talk yourself. That's, y'all know, it's a big slogan of mine. Do that shit. Just do the motherfucker. And if it don't work out, either try to restructure it to make it work for you, or maybe it just wasn't what you needed to be motherfucking doing in the first place. Sometimes that is the truth. It's hard to tell ourselves this ain't really what I need to be doing.
Yeah.
Because you put so much effort behind it. Man, I almost did that with this show. I didn't. Thank God. I'll be at the crib bored as hell during Wednesdays. I'll be having shit else to do, y'all. I'm tired of playing 2K. I just bought it. Shout out to my child for getting in trouble so I can have his Xbox.
What do you do?
So my son, I tell him I'll make him go to bed at 8:30.
Yeah.
And I was like, but you can watch TV till 9.
Yeah.
That's cool. Just chill. Just give you a little wind down time.
Yeah.
So I've been thinking it's weird. Usually he'll never want to go to sleep come to 9 o'clock. But late past week, his ass quickly come in the room to me. Oh, good night, daddy. Woo, I love you. Quickly doing it. I'm like, okay, you know it's your time. Like, you watching the time. You don't never do that. So, the other day, I decided to open his door just to let the dog in.
Yeah.
Because she likes sleeping with him, so she laying out across the floor. But I'm assuming, now that I put the two in together at that time, she was laying across the floor because she kept hearing him. So, I opened the door to let her in.
Mm-hmm.
He has a computer in his room that he used for school.
Mm-hmm.
He's sitting up on the computer playing Roblox throughout the middle of the night. Yeah. Mind you, when I opened the door, it was 11:30.
Mm-hmm.
When I did this.
My daughter do the same thing.
So I was like, I just closed the door. I had just got out the shower. I couldn't even see. I closed the door, went, got all my shit. Listen, let's just say he is not going to be doing that no more. And the only reason it made me pissed is because I was like, this is your first, how many times did you do this? Sometimes I was like, you know what, nigga? What kids don't remember, the internet came out during our era.
Yeah.
So I'm like, bro, I was the one setting up all the computers and everything at my mama's house. My mama would buy a computer, say, put it together.
Yeah.
So I go look. The dumb didn't realize you can delete the browser history.
Mm-hmm.
I go look at the shit. I was wondering why he was so tired the other day at school. Like, I seen him in a blanket in his room. I'm thinking, okay, it's a little cold, whatever.
Yeah.
But I'm like, bro, you super sleepy looking. I'm like, nigga, you get way more sleep than me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. The Negro went to bed at 4:50.
Oh, my God.
The morning, 4:50 that morning, just to get up at 7:45 for school. One time he went to sleep at like 2 o'clock in the morning just to wake up at 5:15 to get back on the computer.
Oh.
I said, no way, Roblox, and you could kiss my ass. So thank you. I put some money on the little Xbox and everything for Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Buy you some games. Nope, you bought me 2K, and I put your. I may put the $30 back on there if I feel like it, depending on what you want to do. I was just like, bruh, you be. He's like, I couldn't sleep. I'm like, yeah, nigga, you couldn't.
Because you was on the computer.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning. That's why your ass can't sleep, bruh. Oh, yeah, me and his mama had to go in on that shit.
He was tripping.
I'll search through that computer, all the type of shit I saw. I'm like, one, luckily it's a work computer, so he couldn't do too much.
Right.
But he was coming across some shit. And he like anime. So clicking on anime is going to pull up all types of weird shit.
Yeah.
I clicked. I'm like, what the fuck is this? I clicked.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And it's crazy because I told his mama a week or so before, and I said, hey, he's big into anime. I'm like, I know. I'm like, I wasn't big in anime, but I'm like, I know they got this shit called hentai.
Yep.
I'm like, if you look for that word on his tablets and shit, because I'm like, he may not initially meant to click on it.
But then he just it's just a hole it that is. You
oh
get
no
in.
That's exactly what it was
because
I told her I was like, girl, I clicked on it. It was all type of weird shit.
Yep.
And I clicked and I was like, I know he at first he didn't know what he was looking at.
But then when like, you see the one thing, it's like, okay, well, what's this? That's what I told her
because I was like, it was some crazy shit. It had all types of stuff, girl, boy, but like weird shit. And so I didn't trip off that because she tripped. She's like, what is he looking at? And I was like, listen, don't trip. I'm like, if that's the case, then that's the case. I'm like, ain't nothing we can do about that.
Right.
But I'm like, we're not going to go off on that shit. I'm more mad at you looking at anime porn at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Right.
At least figure out how to delete the history, my nigga.
Right.
That's the first thing. I did all my history deleted. My mama didn't call me up because I was stupid. But I'm just like, so I go off about that shit. And then I was like, well, Keisha, don't get mad because he was looking at shit. But I'm like, I could see from the first one he looked at to the last one. It was probably maybe 5 minutes in between, which means he's just clicking different pictures.
Yeah.
So it ain't like, but then I was like, bro, this your first time getting on there? He kind of stopped. I said, nigga, you ain't got to answer that for me. No, the first time on my computer was December 4th. He got caught in January.
Right.
So the rest of the month of January, he will be the most book reading this nigga y'all going to know this side of the Mississippi.
And he can join my daughter because she just got in trouble for the same thing.
Yeah.
Same thing. She got the iPad or the iPhone taken. She got her tablet taken.
Oh, yeah.
All
tablet,
that.
iPhone, Nintendo Switch.
All that.
He just got the Xbox for Christmas. Yep. Brand new. I'm like, well, bro, I appreciate it. I've been wanting to get 2K. I put a little money on here for you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, my brother.
Yep.
I greatly appreciate your due diligence to society for being a fuck up. But I do appreciate you for having them straight A's on that report card because that would have been another one.
Right.
So, yeah. That's why I'll be like, bro, you. I was like, listen, you ain't got a lot of me. All the shit you did, I did it.
Right.
But your granddaddy, trust me. I tell him all the time, I'm like, bro, I was the biggest kid liar for no reason to your grandparents. Save me the hassle.
Yeah.
But it's fucked up because when I try to vent to my parents about it,
they be like,
my daddy be like, oh, sound like a nigga named Nico, don't it? I was like,
you don't get nothing.
I was like, nah, because I was looking at real porn for one nigga. If I was going to get caught, I was going to be looking at real ass titties. I wasn't going to be looking at no goddamn cartoons.
Oh my God.
But he learned his lesson. He learned that lesson. I bet he won't do this shit again. And if he does, I bet he'll be a little bit smarter about it.
Oh,
that's all I want. Just don't get caught, bro. You do what you're going to do, you're going to do it. Just don't get caught.
Right.
And at the point, and if you do get caught, just fess up. At that point. He did. I commend him. He fessed the fuck up. It's really hard not to fess up when your mama's sitting there damn near in tears and your daddy's sitting there with a belt.
Aww.
It's like, shit, you're going to talk after a while. Because she's so heartbroken about this, because that's your
aww
mama. I was like, don't trip off that shit. I'm like, I'm a boy. I get it. I get the exploration. So I did trip off of that. But I'm like, bro, if we need to have that talk, let's do that.
Right.
I'm like, my daddy ain't give me that talk.
Right.
That's why your ass was here at 21.
Right.
I'm trying to prevent that shit.
Right.
So it was a wild moment.
Yeah.
But it's crazy being a parent. How old is your?
She just turned 9.
Okay, so he's 10. He'll be 11 in October. I was just like, oh, my God.
Yep, we just went through the same thing.
And she knew it was.
Same
she
thing.
She was pissed. Like, I call his mom. I don't never call his mama for shit.
Mm-hmm.
I call her. It was 11:50 at night. She already nervous. And I was like, is you asleep? She's like, no. I was like, bet. I'm finna Google Duo you.
Mm-hmm.
He looked at me. That's when he started crying. Because he's like, oh, shit. I know that's when the video. I said, I want you to see what your child is. Oh, yeah. I'll say, oh, shut your
ass
up.
See, you sound like her then. I was just sitting there like, I don't know why you telling me. I already told you this. This is why I told y'all she didn't even have had the phone.
See, and that's the crazy part. The phone, he couldn't do nothing. I restricted it. The computer, I know he didn't look for it. He figured out after a while, but he had to click because it's a computer from my last job.
Yeah.
So
it's
super firewall to do. You can't even pull up Netflix on there.
Yeah.
So I'm like, bro, whatever you found out, I know you ain't just, but he realized that was a website he could get on. I'm like, nigga, you searched it after that.
Right.
I'm like, bro, you got me fucked up. So read books, clean. You're going to be washing walls, nigga. We're going to be doing all types of shit.
God.
For the end of January, the month almost over with.
Right. And he'll be all right.
After, I was like, bro, February, you cool, bro. You got your L out the way. I used to get the option. You want to whoop it. Or the grounder.
Right.
I'll take the grounder and still get the whooping and still be grounded.
Right.
So I was just like, look, bro, you only got the whooping because you lied. Like, I don't care about the shit you did for real because I'm a boy. I get it. I'm your daddy.
Right.
Let's figure that shit out now.
Right.
But I'm like, bro, you lying. Your mama here crying. I'm like, I got to do something at this point. You kind of forcing my hand at this point. I didn't want to have to go that far. And my child is hella good.
Yeah.
Like, I tell people, that's why I want another kid because I feel like my next one's going to be the asshole.
Like, yeah,
my child have made it to where parents, I didn't have them parenting woes.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody went through. Like,
yep,
he do everything I needed him to do with no issues, ask no questions. I haven't had to go, like, I go outside to sit your ass down.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to go off about nothing.
Yeah,
I don't have to. Most people, I'm like, bro, you got whoop your kid all the time. I'm like, bro, I don't have to touch that nigga.
Right,
because I just look at him. He already know what it is.
Right,
but that one, it broke my heart. I was like,
But just like you said, he hasn't gotten to that point up until now. So it's like,
and that's why I feel like, but he was, when the first, I ain't had to whoop him in years. Yeah. After that last time, he was like, oh yeah, nigga, this ain't for me.
Yeah.
This not the life I'm trying to live. Yeah. So I'm cool on that.
Yeah.
But man, it is what it is. I'm like, bro, you got your L over with. Move forward, bro. I'm just like, man, you had to have, he knew he was in trouble when me and your mom was both in my house. I was like, oh, your mom here. He got up thinking he finna put his bag on.
He's like, no.
Sit your ass down. She finna come in. He was like, what you mean she finna come in? His mom been there since she moved out. Only been in there two other times. That was to use the bathroom right quick.
Oh.
Like, he know that, like, we good. Like, we got a wonderful co-parenting situation. But it's like, shit, I don't need to be in your crib. You don't need to be in mine.
Right.
But when he knew she here, she was in there a good 45 minutes.
Oh.
He was like,
oh, no.
And I made, you know, you don't want to listen to her. Stand your ass up in the middle of the floor. You better not get tired. I don't want to hear no tears. I'm like, you want to cry? We're using that watching porn and pouring down.
I'll be crying now. No.
Yeah, you got to get the embarrassment of it. It's the whole like, oh, shit. Shit, man. My mom and daddy don't figure this out. It's like, I've been through that embarrassment.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember I was looking up, printing out porn pictures, the fucking printer.
Printing them out.
Yeah, it was wild. It was wild back in the day. Showing them at school. I was like, the good friend.
Showing them at school.
I was good. Yeah, I had a little backpack pouch under
nothing. Child, look, absolutely not. Yeah,
I was trying to prevent that. Hey, I'm a printer. That's the one, though. I had a printer. But one time the printer fucked up, and I thought it was not going to print the shit out.
Uh-huh.
So my mom then figured it out, fixed it. A whole bunch of shit to start printing out that motherfucker. Like it was on the waiting thing. I ain't figured that one out yet.
Mm.
I was like, oh,
she looked like, look at you just print out all this ass.
And my daddy, I'll be hoping he find it. He gonna say something to me, but he don't say nothing to her.
Right.
He'll fold the shit up and throw it on my bed. Nasty ass. Woo, y'all. Y'all had to go off on my tangent. He don't get to listen to the show. I'm gonna make him listen to this episode with his little frisky ass. Sean, shut your little freaky ass down.
I cannot.
Don't be like me. Your grandma had me reading Zhang books and all type of shit, and that's why your ass here now. I used to get in trouble. I had to read books. I read through all the Black History books. It was only Zhang books left after that.
I can
listen. Them motherfuckers is not as niggas. Them books is not as bad as you think.
I've actually never read any of them.
Listen, you talk. I was already a little descriptive mind.
Uh huh.
Oh yeah, look y'all. Shout out y'all. I've been talking to Razzle and Dazzle. We got our guest calling in right now. We got Desmond Mosby. Hold on, bro. What's good, bro? Say your name again because before I press the one, they can't hear it.
Okay.
Yeah, y'all. Look, y'all. We got our wonderful guest, Desmond Mosby, in the building. And Mr. Mover, ATL. What's good with you, bro?
What's good, boss? How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good, man. How about you?
Hey, man, I can't complain, man. I'm out here, man. Enjoying this beautiful day, seeing what's going on with Trump.
Look, I'm already knowing. I know it. If it's nice out, if it was decent out here, I know it was good in Atlanta today. For sure. It was good 50 out here. So, look, tell our listeners and viewers a little about yourself and what you do, bro.
Okay, so me personally, I am a Black entrepreneur, born and raised in Atlanta, Georgia. I have a moving company, a lounge, and a party bus. But I believe in morals over money, and I'm a hard worker, man, part of the community.
Okay, that's what's up. So look, I see you got the company Mr. Moving ATL. What got you interested in owning your own moving company?
So I started off working for somebody making, you know, bare minimum $10 to $12 an hour. I saw how they wrote a check, well, they received a check for about $500 for the hard labor that I did. And from there, I said, you know, I need to be on that side rather than on this side. From there, you know, I purchased a truck, got business financing, saved up my money also, exhausted my resources to everybody that was around me. And voila, I'm here. 5 years in the making.
Okay. That's how it should be. A lot of people don't, especially if you notice it's something like that you're going to do, I'm like, man, look into the money that's made on the back end that you never see. Because I'm like, if they shelling out 10 to 13 an hour for you for the hard labor you're doing and they not doing shit, what you think they pulling just to tell you to go do this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, that's what the U.S. is. But, you know, we got to tap in. See, a lot of us, we don't understand it. We don't have anybody to go chop it up with or to go get the game from. So, you know, we sell.
Look, I'm glad you said, look, fact. And that's the reason, big reason why I created this platform. I try to put black entrepreneurs in different aspects from the first episode I never did because, and I've had people hit me up like, damn, bro, I didn't think to do my business until I listened to such and such, so-and-so on your show and how their story happened and how they got started. And I was like, fuck it, I'm going to do it. I always tell people, do that shit. Mm-hmm. The worst that's going to happen is you going to fail. If you fail because you put in all your hard work, then that's cool. Mm-hmm. But don't fail because you ain't try. Because then you can't blame nobody but yourself.
But yourself. Oh, that's true.
So look, 100%. What cities in the Georgia area do your company service?
So we service, we go worldwide. Okay. So prior to COVID, we were the specific person that delivered everything to Tony Robbins. COVID happened and we kind of scaled back. We don't have any more conferences to go to. So we're in Atlanta. But if anybody needs to move, you need to move to Alaska. You need to move over there to China. We got, we do international, we do metropolitan, white glove service, all of the above, storage, junk removal. We got you. Anything you need.
So look, with the international, is this only, so say if somebody, is this somebody moving from Atlanta to one of these states, or mm-hmm. Could somebody in Missouri call y'all, y'all come to Missouri, get them, and then take them somewhere else?
Yeah, so if that would be, that would be not a problem. We can come to Missouri, take you to New York. If you want to go to New York, if you want to leave New York and you got to go to Tampa, we can do that also. That's so fine. Our home base is Atlanta and the metropolitan area, though.
Okay. So, look, where do you see, like, what are your plans and visions for Mr. Mover ATL within the next 5 years?
Franchising. Okay. So, the next step is to open franchises. I am also looking for any franchisees, any person that was just like me, that was a hard worker, that had dreams of selling trucks. So, mm-hmm. what I'm doing and what I've done and what me and my business partners have done, we set up a module to where anybody can do this. Anybody that believes in themselves, anybody that, you know, has a couple of dollars, you can go out and buy you two trucks and we can get you jobs. So my next place right now, we're looking at either California or Seattle. That's where the next franchise will be.
That's fine. The West Coast, definitely. Yeah. There's big moves happening on the West. There's two states I'm trying to visit within a year, actually. So that's
oh, you got to hit Cali. I love Cali.
Man, look, that's a goal for me. I definitely said I want to hit Cali and Seattle. I've heard a lot of good stuff about, like, Seattle area. So I'm definitely looking to go to Washington. So look, bro, where can our listeners and our viewers in Georgia and hell around the world, where can they find information about you and your business?
If you go to www.MrMoverATL.com, that is Google, whatever. You go check us out on the gram. We're Mr. Mover ATL. If you need to call us directly, we're 855-242-MOVE. Once again, that's 855-242-MOVE.
I appreciate you calling in, rocking with us, giving us that info. People be able to definitely, once they play back, after I upload the episode, like when we end it, it upload on all streaming platforms, Spotify. So you can send folks them episodes. They got all your info as far as your website, your Instagram info in there, so people could click on it and go straight to you and find you.
Hey, man, I dig it. I appreciate it. You keep doing what you do. You know, blessings, peace and blessings to you, brother.
Most definitely, bro. Peace and blessings to you as well, bro. You have a good rest of your evening.
All right, shalom.
Hey, y'all, we're going to clap that up again, man. Shout out to Dave, because when I looked it up, I thought he only serviced the Atlanta area, so that's hella dope. Look, black people, y'all looking for a black moving company in whatever capacity that you need to do. Y'all heard what the man said. If you're in Atlanta, he can move you. If you're further than Atlanta, he'll come to you. You need to go from wherever you at to another place. They will drive and come get you. If you want to create your own box trunk moving company, get you two trucks and have the funds, they have the module and set up to put you in the position and plan to win. You don't really hear that from people. They just be like, oh, most people don't want to teach you the game.
Yeah.
A lot of people just figure that shit out. And this time it actually worked out on behalf of that. So that's hella dope. Like, That's weird. Look, when I move big time, definitely when I get famous, I already know who I'm going to call. I had to do my little razzling and my dazzling for sure. So once again, y'all make sure y'all shout out and hit up the bro, Desmond Mosby, Mr. Mover, ATL. We got one half of the color people section in the building tonight. Yayo, the mother freaking general. She got her fall colors and shit on in this motherfucker. Yeah, you know, I be doing my little palettes and shit. Nigga know a couple pastels and all them. I know ain't no pastels.
I mean, she technically got the little tan and everything.
I had an extended pack of crayons.
Oh, God.
This is our
fashionista. Yes. Oh, yeah, I could tell, baby. You did that.
So, look, you missed it. We had an interview. You know, remember Kendra from Lincoln, her boyfriend in Atlanta, Desmond Mosby.
Oh, he
got a moving company called Mr. Mover ATL. He just called in.
That was super nice.
He moved from Atlanta. Actually, shout out to Kendra Hunt. She actually hit me up like, hey, man, if there's any way, you know, you can get my boyfriend on there.
Oh, that's super dope. Shout out to my roommate.
We fam like that. So straight as soon as she said the word, I was like, I'll figure out where to put him in.
Yeah,
I
had to come to the time.
Look, just made shit shake. So look, y'all, we also do, I didn't get y'all my famous black sports players with the number 50 this time. We got Hall of Famer David Robinson of the NBA, San Antonio Spurs, and Hall of Famer Mike Singletary, NFL Chicago Bears. Shout out to the Shy and all them
people. Okay. It's the 50th episode.
We got liquor.
What you mean?
We got cups in the back.
I told you, Nico.
Look, male ass don't want to show up.
I know. I'm going to pour up for you, sister.
I meant to call her ass.
You are here in spirit.
I drove past the facility, but I think they doing something. Cause I seen,
oh, are they?
I seen lights on it.
Yes.
I don't know if the cars is at the bar. Everybody know my co-host runs a Canna Collective Education.
Ooh.
It is on, it is actually, I don't know the numerical address to it, but it's on West Flow. It's right in that plaza where Q2, the bar is.
Yeah.
She's the building right next to it.
Okay.
So they'll be opening up, I think, if not the end of this month, beginning of next month. Some stuff happened where they couldn't do it last month.
Just about to turn this spicy
on. If you're trying to, if you live in the North County area, you can sign up to get a medical card. I know one portion of it, 600 people a week. They give, I think, either the doctor part. One part of it is free.
Okay.
And North County residents, that's if you want, you can go buy your weed because you know medical, they allow you to grow.
Okay,
all that
I ain't been
shit.
A weed wearing bitch in a minute. Okay.
Listen, make some shit shake.
Because, baby.
Listen, get y'all medical cards, man. Shout out to the plug. She trying to make it's a $1 trillion industry.
Yes, it is.
Black people was taking an L for so long, so why is we not gonna benefit
from it? Yep.
I'll be telling them, I'm gonna move to North County just so I can get that money.
Granted,
we legal in my city, so but I don't go to dispensaries. And I live by two of them. I ain't been in there.
Oh, for real?
They just built a new one in Sanjay.
Oh,
right by Pops, right next to Pops.
What? Quit playing.
It's Pops, whatever that little random like strip club that is like this random warehouse building. I drove past it, and I seen it was making a new location. I've been forgetting. So I'm in Cahokia. All that shit is right there.
Right.
And so Cahokia got, it's a place called Beyond Hello. Cahokia got one. And
I think my homegirl worked there.
And Sajay. I was finna trying to get that shit to get me a part-time job to get a discount on weed. Shit, I'll take that motherfucker too, guys.
Right.
So look, before I go a little further,
is you dumb?
For real, bro. Who don't want a discount on weed, nigga? Like, what?
I think everybody do.
First of all, I'm going to Colorado for my birthday weekend.
Are you, Nico?
I'm going on a little vacation.
When's your birthday?
You go, baby. 2nd.
Thank you.
Ooh, my birthday, March 2nd. I'm going from the 5th through 7th. I'm going on a little vacation and shit.
Are
I'm
you?
Boo thing, yeah.
No! Okay, shout out to Nico!
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to boo
thing. Weekend,
so y'all going to Colorado. That's going to be so nice.
Me and my nigga Dion went on a humbug. August. I had another trip planned with somebody else. That situation fell out.
That's
I still had the days off. I'm like, shit.
Let me find somebody.
Let me find some dude. I knew that nigga would be with it. I was like, I sent out a mass text. We're trying to go to Colorado. I was going to drive. Mm-hmm. I already paid for I was like, I'm going to pay for a room. You just got to have some money on gas.
Right.
Have your money for weed and shit. Right. I ain't asking for no room. And he was like, nigga, what up?
Gotcha.
Look, 3 days later, 12-hour road trip. Mm-hmm. And when kicked, I love Colorado. If you somebody that like weed, I was like, go to Colorado. Colorado straight got coupons for weed.
Coupons.
Hey, they got straight, like, I got an app called Weed Maps. They had this. They tell you all the places they got the discounts and the sales on weed. I went to one dispensary. They gave me a coupon book for different dispensaries with straight. Like, I could cut out this coupon and go buy weed with a coupon. I bought weed with my debit card. Anybody know dispensaries don't even fuck with all cards that, yeah. And shit. So Denver got it set up. I don't know what they was finessing, but Denver got it set up. But hey, Senior Warden, I bought tickets from the 5th through the 7th. For a round trip, two people, we paid $211.
Damn, word.
For each one of y'all total.
What y'all want, Nico?
Combined
together? What y'all?
Southwest.
For real?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, they did that.
It was after taxes. I mean, it was a 105 a person. 105 and
300. Really? For the round?
Round trip a person.
And when
oh,
is
yeah,
this?
Y'all did that.
The 5th through the 7th.
February?
No, March.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
But the South, I don't know about other flights. And people know I ain't been on a plane South 15.
Oh, everywhere I go, I'm happy. It's time to.
Everywhere I go, I always just, and I ain't really went nowhere far.
It's time.
Denver, I should have went last time, but it was last minute. I wasn't finna buy no 3-4.
Right.
Right.
One way ticket to go nowhere. I'm like, hey,
and now you just bought one for $211 for two people?
Listen.
Right.
You snap.
Deal. Mm-hmm. So I was like, man.
Look, strike steel.
I'm finna start looking at deals all throughout the year. I'm like, that's a deal. I'm like, you can't beat that.
That's going to be so exciting.
I was younger trying to fly a plane. I'm like, nigga, we could drive, bro. That shit costs entirely too much. That's what tickets used to be hella.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I didn't realize, I'm like, bro, that shit really ain't that bad. All right. If you cut down, I may pay $50 in gas to get here completely.
Okay.
I saved 10 hours.
Okay. Yeah.
10 fucking hours.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I appreciate that. But y'all heard my wonderful snippet of my stupid, dumber drone. And I hate to get this beautiful woman this.
I know. Right? I was just so shocked when I seen her name. But, like, but is this a typo?
I had to. It wasn't. Carrie Hilson.
Oh, yeah. She been canceled.
She be tweaking. And this
she's
one.
Stupid.
Now, I gave what Carrie Hilson do? This one. I'm going to send you the info, bro. I'm going to send you the info. But I gave Carrie Hilson
say,
this
damn.
One because of her regards to Trump having his social media rights taken away. She said, and I'll motherfucking quote, this may be funny, but it is a little dangerous too. Take Trump out of it for a moment.
No.
A democracy must include freedom of speech. Imagine other leaders or popular figures not being able to voice their opinion if it opposes the majority of the world leaders. Our freedom of speech is being taken away from us. Okay. Clearly, for one, it ain't because you wrote that dumbass shit on your
own. Oh, Karen.
That part.
Second, Trump ain't above the law. He is subjective to any rule we all get when we create our accounts.
Yep.
I've had my shit suspended. I've been in jail for, I couldn't post in groups because I was sharing my flyers. And some groups kept flagging it as spam. I couldn't post in groups at one point for 3 months because people kept, I'm like, why not just delete me from the group?
Right.
It's not that serious. Like, bro, I'm not spamming y'all, nigga. You can go to my page. Clearly, I'm a normal, regular nigga.
Right.
But that's not, neither here nor there.
It's just evident she does not see not only the bigger picture of what this man, like, he is a threat. That's all of what, he's been a threat ever since he came into this presidency. Mm-hmm. And she is not understanding that bigger picture. And I hate to say this about some black people, but she is one of those black people that legitimately, whether it's consciously or not, she just does not understand the magnitude of what this is. This does not have anything to do with free speech. This man has literally put our nation like,
he treated us real. Just like,
do you not understand now that all these meth head white people have easily broken into the White House, that we now are subject one for every other nation that has been beefing with us? And this all has boiled down to how this man has ran the presidency in however many years he has. This ain't got shit to do with free speech, boo boo. Like, she pisses me off. I'm sorry. She can't sing. She can't think. She just need to go in the corner somewhere. I guess she ain't got the African man that she had before. She just need to find a hobby and go sit down.
Yeah, she probably just.
I really felt like she tweaked on that because, one, I mean, they didn't take his freedom. Like, a nigga can't not talk. He just can't. He was pretty much inciting riots without doing it. Like,
but if one of us was to do that.
Oh, we know.
And my thing is, Karen.
That's the whole point.
Did you have the same energy when they stopped Farrakhan from talking on social media sites? Because he got banned from Facebook.
Yep.
I don't know about Twitter, but Facebook, I think he was using a lot. I don't know about Twitter. But did you have that same energy then? Because he is a world leader.
She probably didn't
say
anything.
Didn't say a thing. She probably didn't give a fuck about it.
Right.
So why are you mad the man who has... And look, freedom of speech does not include inciting riots.
Yep.
This man is the single greatest national security threat to a country. Yes.
Okay.
He can say, jump. Them racist motherfuckers gonna say how high?
How high and with what? Like, you want me to go with the bare shoes? You want me to go just...
Literally. And good, I'm glad we're talking about this because it's leading into the other portion I had before this. Do you feel these motherfucking terrorists of the United States that attacked the Capitol are receiving the backlash or ramifications they deserve?
Fuck no.
Like, they're not, I appreciate the niggas.
They are
put them on the no-fly
list. Any, so what? They got so arrested. So what? We would have got shot.
We would have been dead.
Shot
not even
first,
heard to tell the story.
Questions later. Not even questions. Let's
they
figure out
sent
how
so
to
many
make
people
this
in
look good for the
yes.
news. So that way we can cover it up. So basically shoot first, cover it up, and then figure out a story to
yeah.
present to the
no,
press.
No, they keeping it. They trying to keep it. They trying to save them. They keeping it real cute
why
still.
Are these yeah. police officers who are clearly on video taking pictures, video. I seen videos of niggas like, shit. This ain't got nothing to do with me.
Why
do
you ain't
building.
The brightest bulbs
nah.
in the
crazy part is, like, and the white people that agree with the shit are, oh, somebody gave you a shout out. The queen with the low cut, gold hair is smart. She's kind. She's
okay, queen.
For real, queen is on point.
Yes.
That is a man.
It better be.
One of my good worthy brothers.
You're saying
out here in the world.
You heard me, sis.
Thank you.
Okay.
Look,
okay.
Like, look, if you ain't got no baby mama issues, because I don't deal with that, if you ain't got no diseases, hit my inbox.
Okay. Say that STD free.
Y'all heard the word out here, okay. Y'all. But it was like, why them officers not? Y'all motherfuckers need to be going to jail, too. Did y'all know a U.S. two-time Olympic gold
yep.
medal swimmer was one of the people?
Yep.
That ran up in there.
Look, what type of... But could you think... Okay, just...
The nigga wore his Olympic U.S.
Just
like a dumb... Well, not even like a dumbass, because just, they knew... They know what they're doing. I'm sorry.
He had a beard this time.
Think about the caliber of Europeans we talking about here that really took the time out. One bitch flew on a private jet just to do this shit.
Motherfuckers drove
hours. I'm confused at to...
And look, another thing... Somebody said Trump banned from social media, but he still got the code to the nuclear shit.
That's true.
And crazy, Trump is the first nigga to get impeached twice. A lot of people are like, why would y'all impeach him twice? For those that don't understand why they made this happen the second time, remember, you get 8 years to be a president, max. Trump only did 4-piece. This impeachment stops him from running
again
within the next 4 years.
Please.
And stops him from receiving, and I looked this up,
because
presidents, when you become a president, you get paid $400,000 a year to be president. After you retire, the security of Treasury Security, one of them names, they send out your pension every year.
Yep.
They get paid $219,200 a year just for being president.
Yeah.
Him being impeached stops him from getting that money and from being able to run again.
Okay.
Which I think is well deserved. One, he don't need the money.
Well deserved. No.
Like, I tell people every time we bring up Trump, Trump literally became president. I feel like he was sitting with his homeboys blowing a blunt. He's like, no, I'm going to run for president. I was like, nigga,
yeah,
you can't
it was
do
a
it.
Joke.
He put that bitch out and said, okay, bet. That was one of them say less moments.
Yeah,
he did what he had to
and
do.
I'm
he
about
proved
to do
money
it.
Can buy what you it want for real, even though we been knew that.
Right.
But that was he proved a fact. Money can buy what you want.
He did
and as soon
that.
As he got that shit, he called all the homeboys up and said, y'all said a nigga couldn't do what?
I'm the president.
Say less. Boom, I'm the fucking
president.
Me personally, if I was Trump after I did my 4-piece, I wouldn't have even tried to run again. I proved my point.
No.
Because when he won, you saw the look on his face. Like, I fucking won this shit.
He couldn't believe it.
He confessed, like, y'all niggas dumb enough to fucking vote for me? Yeah. And the only thing, I give Trump one respect factor.
Yeah.
The fact that I respect a motherfucker that's going to be openly about what they is. If you going to be racist, if you going to not like me, let me know that shit so I know how to move with you.
And here's my thing. So if anybody has not seen his Netflix special, I highly suggest that everybody sees his Netflix special.
Okay.
Just because it puts everything into play and it makes sense as far as like why he thinks how he thinks and like why kind of every... Like, here's the thing. A lot of people don't understand like his whole business mindset and stuff like that. And a lot of his voters like kept voting for him just because they realized or thought in their minds that he was like a great businessman.
No, I got you.
He's bankrupt, actually. If there's any businesses out there that have his name, and it says it even in the documentary, they only put his name or keep his name on there for basically press because Donald J. Trump. But he doesn't own it. Yeah. So it just shows, and he even talks about like how he wants to move into a position of power because he feels like he knows how to talk to people and influence them, but he's not going to do anything to back up any of the promises that he's going to eventually make. So you can watch that Netflix episode and literally see everything that he said he wasn't playing about. He wanted to see basically how far he can go with his family's money and the bestowed
quote-unquote power
that he claimed that he had basically from how he grew up.
Thanks. This is the same as started off with a small business loan of $1 million from his dad. Small, nigga, you give me $1 million.
And then he even fucked that up. So basically, after him and whatever his first wife's name is, Ivanka, because she was the one that was actually in the businesses. Like, she was there every day, like, meeting with the staff and all that stuff. And after they divorced, that's when all his stuff went down because he kept taking more than what he had.
Yep, and that's what it is. Living living without outside your mean. Hell, we as normal people who don't have those funds do that too much.
I do.
Living outside of my motherfucking means faithfully, then you be at the end of the week like,
woo, boy.
Like, shit, can you cash me $10?
Look, okay. I've been through the malls where
My mama be holding me down like, look, give me $10 so I can pay.
What I got into lately.
Especially after Christmas, how they tried to rape me on Christmas, boy.
Try having a child 2 days before Christmas. Ooh. Her birthday is the 23rd, 25th, and then my birthday and my brother's birthday is the 15th.
Ooh. Oh yeah, you got no lube.
Look, I was like, Mama, I need to move in for about a month because this ain't it.
I've been telling folks, you got an opportunity, you ain't embarrassed. Do that shit. I wish I didn't leave as little soon as I did. But Carrie, I just want you to know,
what the fuck did you do that for?
Like, that was stupid. You hella drove for that shit. And y'all, we're gonna go on a quick commercial break. We've been rocking strong for 52 minutes.
Okay.
We've been in this thing, man. It's episode 50, a hot topic.
I love that. And then it went with my segment.
Y'all gonna find out why I named it this, because hot, spelled the way it is, has something to do with this wonderful woman here.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're the only because of you, I got one song that deviated from my music.
Oh, I had no, didn't care.
Yeah, I know you didn't. That's why I put it. I told people, she
thank
don't care.
Thank you.
That'll play on after her segment. We're going to come back, but I got two songs.
What was you on today with the music?
I got some old.
No Limit Studios. What's up?
Who this is? Who this is?
Look at this rapping folk tell you. Who is this?
Oh, this P.
P?
Yeah, this P.
P?
Yeah.
P, let me hear you say, This ain't no motherfucking P, man.
Hang the phone.
Intimidated by the rounds that a tank shoot. Tank dogs salute. Every robbery is gone. your shit. Then after they say, nah, 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 nah. I hang with niggas. I do my thing with niggas. They wanna know if I gang bang, cause I hang with a whole gang of niggas. So when we connect, bitch, better respect is a step quick. Cause I got a bitch's white hand, but you know what? My left is quick, too. You the type of nigga that promotes violence. You might be right, so I step in the club and say something, get that motherfucker start to fighting. Bad bold, I'm cold, as you can see. BG, they fuck my niggas out, cause them niggas see. All 3D. PD's the game, and I spit. No limit soldiers off my back. I run this motherfucker, true niggas. And I bet y'all make it safe.
Back, back.
Keep pistols drawn and cocked. We got the industry locked. We can't be stopped. Too hot. Check the spots that we got on Billboard. Tanked instead of roadblocks. We fading all you hoes. Want some more? Then let's go. Stretch it out like elastic. Zip that ass up in plastic. Have your foes picking caskets. We drastic. Our tactics is homegrown in the ghetto. So feel the wrath of this sister. It's like you're fighting 10 niggas. Forget the baby voice. It's the biggest mama mia. The unladylike diva. Lyric old man either. Believer or steer. And get that ass embarrassed. Egg your decision maker. Guaranteed you'll get carried away. So stay in your place when you hear mama speaking. Cannon spray clear the way when you see the tank creeping.
Hi, I'm that nigga that rap. Pick up chill when they won't know how to do it. Used to be the limit to see the motherfucker with the bread and say, you deliver all the opportunities. I done paid my dues, but they'll play the blue. Nigga play me like you was scared to lose. I'm still a fool. You ain't heard the news. I wasn't no limit, nigga, make a major move. Won't stop now, bitch. If I can't stop, you can't stop me. So, bitch, don't try me. You true soldiers. We don't die. We keep rolling. Nah, 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 nah. All the boys be taking bed inside the group on hallelujah. Niggas going to war. Got to fight and shooting. It's our rumors. 50 saying he there. We there. Beware. See there. Still with that fiend there. Mama there. Be there. Ain't no salary cap on top of my dollars. I roll with nothing but them no limit riders. I get down, nigga. I hold my tank up high. Watch how many bitches get wild. Nah, 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 nah.
Ago on Headland and the Low, what's the starter? Something good, where me and my nigga rode the martyr through the hood, just trying to find that hook up. Now every day we looked up at the ceiling, watching ceiling fans go round, trying to catch that feeling off instrumental. Had my pencil and plus my paper, we caught the 86 fly on your head to Decatur, writing rhymes, trying to find our spot off in that light, light off in that spot. Knowing that we can rock, doing a hole in the wall club. This shit here must stop. Like freeze, we making the crowd move, but we not making no G's, and that's a no-no.
A 1-2, dope niggas in the Cadillac, they call us. Went from Plagueis ball to ball, putting the South up on the map. It's like Little Rock to banging. Niggas say, motherfuck that plaguing. They paying, we staying, legging vocals, locales done. Made it with them big boys up in this industry, outcast. Yeah, them niggas, they making big noise, over a million sold to this day. Niggas, they take it like they 96, gonna be that year that all y'all Plagueis hitters can bite me.
Me
around this bitch,
your mama and your cousin too. Rolling down the strip on poles, coming up slamming Cadillac doors. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too. Rolling down the strip on poles, coming up slamming Cadillac doors.
Back in the day when I was younger, hunger, looking to fill me belly with that rallies. Bullshit, pull shit off like it was supposed to be pulled. Full of the chick I was, stone like them white boys. Smoking them white girls before them blunts got chrome. Chunky asses, passes getting thrown like Hail Marys, and they looking like Halle Berry. So, so fine, intertwined. But we ain't sipping wine, we just chilling. I'm the rabbit, the villain. And I'm so high, smoking freely. Me, Lil B, Reek, Moan, and Suge, and my little brother James. Things changed in the hood where I live at. Them rats know. Mama, I want to sing, but mama, I want to trick. And mama, I'm sucking dicks now. We moving on up in the world like elevators. Me and the crew, we pimps like 82. Me and you like Tone.
Yeah, yeah. Like this East Point and we gone. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too.
mall the other day. Heard a call from the other way that I just came from. Some nigga was saying something, talking about smoke something.
You remember me from school?
No, not really, but it kept smiling like a clown. Facial expression looking silly, and it kept asking me, what kind of car you drive? I know you paid. I know y'all got buku with poles from all them song that y'all done made. And I replied that I've been going through the same thing that he has. True, I got more fans than the average man, but not enough loot to last me to the end of the week. I live by the beat like you live, check to check. If you don't move your feet, then I don't eat, so we like neck to neck. Yes, we done come a long way like them slim ass cigarettes from Virginia. This ain't gonna stop, so we just gonna continue. Continue.
And you, your mama and your cousin too, rolling down the strip on poles, coming up slamming Cadillac doors. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too, rolling down the strip on poles, coming up slamming Cadillac doors. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too, rolling down the strip on poles, coming up, slamming Cadillac doors. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too, rolling down the strip on poles, coming up, slamming Cadillac doors. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too, rolling down the strip on poles, coming up, slamming Cadillac doors.
Oh, turn up, turn up, turn up.
Yeah.
We back. Episode 50. Ethnic issue more. Shout out to Yayo. We sipping on the Bel Air Gold.
Sipping on Bel Air.
We
smoking on Bel Air.
Episode 50. Okay. Shout out Mo Shooter. Love Wave. I Rami Rock.
Truth.
Shout out AK
yes.
Brown in the motherfucker.
Yes.
Shout out Desmond Mosby and Mr. Movers ATL.
Okay, Des.
And shout out to Melanie Marie, y'all. She
shout
missed out
to
on
Swiss.
The night, so we couldn't get plugged in.
Missy.
But. We got to holler at my nigga.
Yes.
The podcast host formerly known as Yayo the General.
Because I had upgraded my life.
AKA Yayo LaFleur.
Period.
BKA LaFleur if you nasty.
Because I get nasty, baby.
Oh,
so,
okay.
We got Yayo. I put Yayo Duh LaFleur. I'm going to take out from the fuck the Duh. Yayo LaFleur presents.
Hotels. Hey, everybody.
Today?
I'm just so happy to be here for real. Y'all know I be taking hiatuses, but I'm be back, and I'm not going anywhere. So let's just get right into it. So today's segment is called Hotels. It's tailored to Jasmine Sullivan's new album that
Which
she dropped.
Which is a bop, because I listen to it.
Period
bop.
And
I'm
poop.
I'm talking about it's a straight-through bop.
Whole straight-through bop. It's so different from what we're used to when we're talking about Jasmine Sullivan. Voice still strong. She just giving us the real
she
right now. Because she's sniggity snatched, okay? She's looking fine.
Okay.
And voice is stronger than it's ever been. So she hit us all across the head with this album last week. Now, the theme of it is little interludes that are all connected to different experiences of women.
Yeah.
So I'm like, hmm.
I didn't look into it.
There's like, there's
though, because I heard the talking.
There's like
talking,
15 to 20 minutes or 20 second segment.
Yes, okay.
I
think about 20
really
seconds. And so, boom, after you hear that, she goes into the song that's hitting on the exact tale that the hoe just told type shit.
So I wonder if she got did she get the clips first and make the songs after them, or did she make the songs?
She probably made the songs and got the clips.
Yeah.
And she probably experienced this herself. You know what I mean?
Homegirls been.
Period. Yeah. She had Ari Lennox on one. You would be surprised if she said.
They played that in the rink last night.
Did they for real?
Went crazy in that bitch.
Did they say they played that sit on?
I was like.
I know.
I'm listen. Everybody know I go skate for slow music. And as soon as I heard that, I was like.
What you said to.
He goes
he say he had like, yeah, look
with
okay. Okay.
For slow music. I love
you go with your boo thing.
Can she skate? She can skate, Nico.
She
can
skate. I'll take her. My first day we went skate.
Aww. Nico, you got the horns, bro. That's that Pisces, bro. That's that water side. That's what's up, bro. Ain't that so sweet? Okay, so boom. So of course I get inspired by the album because it's super dope. I always fuck with her. So it posed the question. Why is it such a double standard between men and women when women want to explore their sexuality with different men? We don't have to, as single women, fuck with the same guy. We can fuck with different niggas if we want to, if we so choose.
Right.
I feel like as a single woman, you should be able to explore your sexual endeavors because he may not be able to do it for you. He may not fuck you good, but he may got some motherfucking money and he like to show you off and you gonna do that. It's different levels to that shit.
Mm-hmm.
But why when women, you know what I'm saying, like they do their thing, men, they been doing they shit since the beginning of time. Society. We straight loose, we some hoes.
Society.
Period. So look. And I've been trying to get society on the main line so that I can tell them what I want.
I'm not coming to that because I agree 1,000%. Because yeah. I stand tall, I say this all the time. I'm like, hey, baby, that's your coochie and you grown.
Okay.
Whatever you do with that motherfucker does not behoove me at all.
As long as you're being responsible.
As long as you're being responsible.
Thank you. You take care of yourself. It's just doing you. Yep. This your body.
Another thing I always look outside of society is also the mentality of the person that's being called said name. Because you could call a nigga a hoe, nigga be like,
that
okay.
is true.
Okay?
Okay.
But when you
what
some
that
women
to...
you call a hoe, they take offense to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
I got a homegirl right now, you be like, you a hoe? She be like, okay, tell me something I don't know.
Baby, okay.
Okay. What can you
okay.
say to a nigga that's
saying that? Absolutely shit.
All of your comebacks
shit.
At that point.
Because I'm an ethical man. Hoe, okay? I have ethics behind the look, hoeing that I
all
choose.
All of your comebacks after somebody said their response is null and void because you be like,
period.
Damn, I was going to call you some old hoes.
Okay.
Okay. But you accept it.
Right.
You accept you. It's only a negative
connotation from who receiving it. Yeah. It comes from the receiver. The time, but you just think about it. You know, just think about a group full of guys that seeing a bad bitch or any female. She ain't even got to be a bad bitch. Yeah. Just be like, that bitch a hoe. Well, what defines
what,
that?
Right,
what makes
what
her
is
that?
Your definition of a hoe?
I think women will.
And women do that to men,
listen,
too.
They, I got
to
admit
women
that.
Do that to other women.
Yeah.
I think when another woman ooh. Call another woman a hoe.
Say this, sis.
My big, when a woman call another man a hoe, I use it as you think I'm cute. You think, one, you think I got this many women.
Right.
You crazy. Whatever.
I that's me, too. I'll be like, I do not have niggas.
Like, hey, you a hoe. I'm like, well, I appreciate you thinking that many women think I'm as cute as you do. That's exactly
period, because that's what you think. Yeah.
But I think when a woman calls another woman a hoe, it's because she's jealous
thank
and that she's living
yes.
the life
she
that
is,
she
wants
to live.
Yep, that's
but
true.
But she doesn't have the self-consciousness about it.
Yeah, she don't got
the
confidence.
Or she worried about what the next motherfucker
period.
Gonna say.
Because you got to be you unapologetically, period.
You don't fuck with the nigga she wanted.
And you single woman? Damn right. I could care less if you fuck 3 niggas in 1 week, bitch.
Yeah,
I bet you.
For finding somebody on Tinder and fucking him when I went to New York.
That's what Tinder is for.
It is
hunting. Hunting. I had the appointments every Tuesday.
I'm
on Tinder.
How am I getting called a hoe?
I mean, that's what you choose. You can't call me no hoe.
Two grown consensual people.
Yes, you
ain't nobody
forced
me to do nothing. Ain't nobody rape me.
Is you mad?
If anything,
is you mad? Cause I know how to get mine. Okay,
here's the address. Come on, can you bring some Hennessy?
Okay, so I can get loosened up.
But I feel that way. It's a society.
I've been trying to get society on the main line. I need
a
conference
call,
with their ass.
I'll just be like, whatever. That don't bother
right.
me. Because one, if you're not doing what people believe you to do, that shit don't nothing. Somebody can't call me something where I feel like it's going to bother me.
Oh,
if
me.
It ain't true.
But then on top of that, why does it matter? So hypothetically, whatever definition you use hoe as, why does it matter what the other person is doing? If it's not affecting you, and I feel like that on any type of situation or any type of like issue, why does it matter what this other person is doing if it does not affect you?
Because people hate how other folks freely live their life because
they
can't do it. And not because they can't, because they won't bring themselves
to do it. Yeah, say that.
Like, everybody's stunning on Lori Harvey. Like, that woman young. She's supposed to do this.
And she beautiful.
The only reason y'all know what she's doing is because she's rich and them niggas rich.
Yeah.
And y'all know she's Steve Harvey's daughter, but that ain't even his real daughter.
It's always a broke motherfucker talking about what somebody rich doing.
Like, oh yeah,
it's definitely. Always people who ain't. I'm like, I'm not even in her tax bracket.
Because if you
concerned.
Think about it, this
if baby want to add me to the list.
Let's think about.
That,
let's just like, think about celebrities
about
yeah.
and the number of celebrities that have been with each other and different people. How they hop in and out of relationships publicly. They doing this
that's
shit. So nobody, ain't nobody said nothing to their motherfucking ass.
So why y'all worry about my old regular schmegler?
Regular
schmegler
ass.
That's different.
My little black and mild smoking ass dick.
Okay.
The same shit she do on a public scale is the same shit a lot of women or. Men do on a normal scale. We just not in the public
eye. In the public eye, yeah.
But locally, motherfuckers are like, damn, that motherfucker be in and out of the
so
shit.
What?
But that's not my business.
But that's not at all.
And if I think if you feel that way about them, then that means you're
but
woman.
We see
don't
it like that, though,
it ain't got nothing to do with your dick.
We
your
see
pussy.
It like that.
Mind your business. Move on.
Because celebrities
and
maybe, do it
freely. Maybe worry about yourself.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, you most likely ain't probably
the celebrities do that shit freely.
In order to even do something with.
You see how many motherfucking people Kim Kardashian fucked and still met Kanye? Still married her.
And got a whole bunch of children.
With
like,
that nigga. Come on, man.
Kids, and now finna get a divorce.
Right. She got 4 kids. Yes. She got
that
surrogate.
Last one was a surrogate one.
Yeah,
because
she can't handle no more kids or she'll die. Basically.
Oh, wow. Fuck them kids.
No, it's 4. Yeah, so, but to that point, it's like, if it ain't got shit to do with you, your pussy, your dick, why does it matter? Like,
period.
It just shows how sad your life is. Yeah,
no,
opinion.
Seriously.
I'm calling women hoes because I be knowing what I done did in my life.
And it shows how small-minded you are, too, that is even a factor. So, boom, that just leads me to the next bullet point. Why is there, I feel like sometimes it's an expectation as women that we have on ourselves to be good girls. Like, we want to show and prove. Like, let me show this nigga that I'm loyal. Let me show this motherfucker, but you can't. You only could just be you. So if you get you a nigga who making you feel a way where you like, man, I don't want to fuck with nobody else. I'm going to just rock with him. Yeah. It's an expectation to be a good girl, but you just doing you, but at the same time, you see all the hoes is the ones who getting wife. Come on, you can move in.
Right.
I think the bitches that are some hoes, because there's some hoes out here now.
Hoes be getting wifed up now. And
they bullying them.
They did a whole lot of thotties that we don't know about leading up to this, so now they tired of
now them. Now they tired of horns. Like, so they bullying them into wifing them, but we all still know your past. Now, it's some diabolical hoes out here. I ain't talking about single women that's do them.
It's some motherfuckers that deserve
it's really
title,
some hoes out here. Every woman I know, hoes. It's some hoes
it's some
now.
People that do deserve the title, hoes.
They
like,
do,
man,
bitch.
Nobody coochie,
okay,
baby,
but you done got,
you done
yes, you
I
have
no comment. My head hurt. I can't.
Baby, okay.
I know some people that done did some things.
But them be the ones that get wife. I know some hoes right now that got that ring. What did you do? Did you suck them clean? Did you suck them clean?
You ain't never had it happen.
And then, he got mesmerized. Like, oh my damn!
Let me wipe this. Oh, let me wipe this hoe. Okay.
Yeah. Put some shit on you sometime. You be
baby
like, bitch,
this.
Where you get that from?
Look,
in short, worry about your business. If she want to live her whole life, if you not trying to intertwine with that whole life, or stop it, nigga, then move on about your business.
Period.
You can't call nobody a hoe. You ain't trying to make your girlfriend.
Thank you. Say that, Nico. Say that shit, Nico. Say that shit, Nico, bro.
That you can't even afford to fucking make your girlfriend.
And a lot of niggas will call you a hoe off of a being turned down.
Yeah.
Off of hearing about you fucking other niggas.
Or a bitch.
I'm like, bro, you fucked. Nah,
that bitch
a hoe. Such and
so.
I'm like, nigga.
So then how you know she a hoe?
How you even know she a hoe?
You don't know what she actually doing.
But yeah, like you said, if you ain't trying to go to that next level and be exclusive, you don't know if that hoe, she fucking with you and fucking with him, just like how you fuck with me and you fucking with her. Period.
And then on top of that, and I don't even know if this got shit to do with it, but my whole thing is this. I can't even get into a relationship unless I know exactly what the fuck it is.
Okay.
So, in my opinion, it's more so performing due diligence before we even make that fucking commitment.
It is so true.
No, I feel like everybody, I even tell people that I've talked to before, I'm like, everybody, look, we ain't at that point yet. Do you? Do you? Because what if we don't get there? Now you're
exactly
wasting
all
your time on me. I don't waste it all my time.
That's so true. You can't right now. I feel like we forgot
but
about
you
the whole.
When it's mutual. You could tell when y'all are
of course.
The phone.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, we talk every fucking day.
I can
like,
see
oh,
this.
Every day.
You
all
like,
day.
You be like, I can see this. You
multiple
like,
times
I can
a day.
Push me my shit.
I push
you
do
your
shit.
Caster, if you looking.
For real. For real. And I think we forgot the dating stage of just being grown because we used to just puppy love and shit.
Oh,
I know I am.
Damn.
I'm speaking from experience. Just puppy love, just that you know what I'm saying, that old school shit. Now we're actually dating and it takes time. You can't just rush into that motherfucking relationship. You don't know if you want to be with that motherfucker forever.
Yeah.
That's why it's called dating. That's why dating, you see other people.
To weed out the motherfuckers that ain't on
exactly,
your level. To weed out the motherfuckers that are wasting your,
that wasting your time.
To weed out the motherfuckers that you may not even be
attracted to
like
in the next 2 months. You may not like some shit.
Because
they may
look good on the outside, but then when you actually get down to the root of it,
thank
they probably
you.
Got so many goddamn issues
so many
to the
demons.
Point where they need a therapist. They don't need a girlfriend. They need a therapist. They don't need a motherfucking wife. And I'm not
there
playing therapist. I don't have a
there
psychology degree.
Say that, sis.
Talk
the fuck?
Shit.
Say that shit.
Like, I don't
because
get paid.
Because I want you to come
that.
To me whole. I don't want you to come incomplete.
Well, not even the fact of whole. It's like, I don't want you to come to me
with
a whole bunch of fucked up ass problems to where, like, you're going to project that insecurity and that bullshit on me. Like,
instantly.
You can still be growing and still be evolving into the man or into my significant other that you're meant to be, but if you're coming with a whole bunch of bullshit, absolutely not. You need to take your ass to a therapist. I know a few. I could refer you to some.
Okay.
But I'm not the person for you because I've already done my work. I've already gone to a therapist. I've already fought my demons and all the other and all bullshit. The shit that you had to and get I'm through. Still continuing. Yes. You know, I consider my therapist my life coach at this point. So I'm continuously trying to do the work to make sure that I'm the best woman that I could
be
for my potential husband. If you're not doing the work too, then why are you with me? Or why are you even trying to pursue this? Because at the end of the day, you only gonna be a dick appointment. That's it, that's all. And Ooh. Even then, I have a satisfier.
Ooh,
a toy that makes you do some things that you ain't never experienced with a man, you may just get kicked out the door and I'll just play with my satisfier and go to bed.
Well, yeah, please give me the details upon that.
AdamandEve.com.
After on the break.
$29.99.
We're going to manage y'all. We're going to play one quick song before we go on our quick interview with AK Brown.
I made a profile on Tinder, since you left me to be with her. The thing that means I'm getting desperate, wish I could return the sender, but you don't love me no more. And I don't even know what for. Knew it was real when you blocked me, now I sit at home judging my body. Wondering what I did to lose you. Why in the hell you ain't choosing? Why you don't love me no more? Yeah. And I don't even know what for. Nah, you just wanted something different. Still don't know what I was missing. What you asked I would give. It ain't right how these hoes be winning. Why did you win? Yeah, no hopeful girl like me. How come they be winning? Yeah, and I ain't wanna be, but you gon' make a whole out of me. Yeah, you gon' make me a gold digger. Maybe I should look like a stripper, wearing fashion over dresses, while these dudes be so pressed and impressed. What if you leave me with no choice? Can't do this good girl shit no more. You're just wanting something different. Still don't know what I was missing. What you asked I would've given. It ain't right how these hoes be winning. Yeah, they be winning. No hopeful girl like me. How come they be winning? And I ain't wanna be, but you gon' make a whole out. Get a hold of me. Look what you did, kid. Get a hold of me. See what you did to me.
Fishing more a hot topic.
I love the hot topic because it was hotel and hot topic.
Look, we had a
think
good,
about that
good,
shit.
Good
hotel and hot topic.
God damn it.
I love it.
Listen, y'all, we got to chop it up with the wonderful A.K. Brown.
Hi.
St. Louis, y'all. So, look, tell our listeners and our viewers a little about yourself and what you do.
Oh, my God. I do everything. So, I am a fashion blogger, influencer. I'm a stylist, so I do everything from personal styling, wardrobe styling, editorial styling. I own my own PR business geared towards fashion and creative brands. And I am also a creative director and owner of my own clothing line.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yes.
So what got you into the fashion industry?
Oh, wow. I've always loved fashion ever since I was like 12 or 13. From my aunt, that's just something that we always connected with. I would just remember she would like have us do these like sewing projects, like sewing a pillow and then sewing this and sewing that. So I've always been into fashion from the earliest that I can remember.
Okay. So look, what do you feel is one of your biggest accomplishments to date? Because you've been making some moves every time I look on Facebook. And it seemed like, especially since the pandemic hit.
Yeah.
Because I know you took, I feel like you took full advantage.
Of me being fired? Yeah. That's what happened. And so I worked for a product development company here in St. Louis. A lot of people actually did not realize that I used to be a product developer. They don't even know what product development is, that we had a company here in St. Louis that did that. So I was in charge of getting hats, scarves, and gloves made for like Fila, Urban Outfitters, and companies like that.
Oh, wow.
So I was doing that for almost 5 years. And I saw the virus happen in December of last year. Y'all knew about it in March. I knew about it in December. We got sent home in February. I got laid off or fired in April. So my whole thing was this. I've been actually doing this or been in the industry for 8 years as of January 5th. And I was begging to get out of that job. Like, I was crying almost every other day at that job. I've seen my coworkers have to get on antidepressants being at that job. And so it wasn't the ideal way that I wanted to exit out of that job, but I was out. So I basically had to come to Jesus with myself. Like, this is your time.
Yeah.
You don't know when and if you're going to get another job. Like, you need to hone in and be consistent right here, right now, because if not, you don't even need to be doing this anymore, and you just need to let it go. And so I would say, I guess my biggest accomplishment, I've been featured 2020 from everywhere, from Fashion Bomb Daily to EXO Nicole to St. Louis Magazine to Deluxe Magazine. I actually have a feature coming out right now with Ledoux News. St. Louis Fashion Fund is trying to work with me. So if anything, it was just more so actually being able to get some of the features that I've been working for 8 years. Like, and mind you, I've been doing it for 8 years, but so 2020 would have been 7 year. And I was talking to my friend, she told me like the number 7 apparently is something of symbolic meaning. Like, it means something. It means like everything is aligning.
Okay.
So like, just for me to be able to say that, like, I was featuring all these outlets that I've always dreamed of being featured in, that's probably my biggest accomplishment
to
date.
That's what's up.
Thank you.
So how did the Black and SEL fashion picture come about?
Woo, okay.
That shit was fire. If you ain't seen
thank
it. It's dope fiction.
Well, thank you. And we're actually in the process of expanding on it. We're trying to do a coffee book edition. So we're going to try to gather 100 to 150 Black fashion creatives in the industry and create a coffee book. But for us, it's going to serve as like an index. So that's in the works. But around October of 2020, I basically was talking to not only my best friend, but I consider her my creative director, Courtney. I was like, look, I want to do a group photo shoot. I don't know how we're going to figure out how to do this, but I want to get together some people that I know that are killing it in the game. And it was literally more so me booking the space.
Okay.
I picked 25 people, but only about 14 of us showed up, which is fine because I understand schedule conflicts and all that stuff. So just pick the day, the time. I want everybody to wear black because black is beautiful and we're
it
black
is.
And that's beautiful. Honestly how it was. And because I do PR as my other business, I headed up the whole PR campaign. So I started to pitch it to numerous outlets. And then, you know, actually, Ledoux News was one of the first people to actually pick up on it. And I didn't even pitch to them. Like, she found the picture, liked it on Instagram, then hit me up in my DMs asking if I can get, or she can get my email. And then she hit me up saying, I want to cover this. I have to submit it. It may be a few weeks, but I'm trying to cover it. And then after that, St. Louis Magazine came up and okay. then covered it too. So. That's how the group photo came about.
That's what's up. That's
thank you.
Good. So look, you kind of mentioned it already. You are a fashion designer. You have
yeah.
your own line.
Yes.
So it is called LA
1962.
So kind of tell people how that name came about and when they can be looking out for it.
So LA 1962, it originally was actually called Lawrence Anthony. That's my dad's name backwards. So it's his first and middle name backwards. He actually gave me the idea of a clothing line when I was 16. We were at a family reunion, and I don't know if he was joking or not, but it stuck with me. He was like, you just need to take my name and switch the Les. You know, these white people gonna go for it. I'm like, oh,
okay, Dad.
But it stuck. He's passed on. It will be actually 4 years in April. Aww. And me and my brother are actually really trying to figure out how to launch it because we want to do it in his... in his legacy, and my brother is the namesake. He has the same name. So,
oh, yeah.
And trying to figure out a good marketing tool, I was like, all right, let me see what LA 1962 sounds like. And I even had cousins like, what is that?
It sounds like it
comes from like California or something. I'm like, it's the Lawrence Anthony brand. So, LA 1962 is going to be a very high-end, elevated streetwear luxury brand. And that's basically what it is. We are actually in the process of developing our first rollout. We're not going to necessarily do like an entire collection or a line drop just because of how fashion is going. I don't predict that seasons are going to matter at this point. That's another conversation for another day. So we're going to start rolling out some of our exclusive moto jackets, blazers. They're going to have some cool embossed details,
yes.
All that. So, and I'm hoping actually to get rolled out so I can be able to wear it to New York Fashion Week next month.
Yeah.
So official launch, I would probably say October 2022, which is actually the month of my dad's birthday. Okay. But if it's going to be sooner, I'll definitely let the public know. But that's kind of like how we're, you know, that's kind of how we're moving right now.
Well, good. So where can our listeners and viewers find information about you and your brand?
So I'm everywhere at AK Brown STL on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Clubhouse, because I know that is the new and popping social media platform. So Clubhouse, AK Brown STL. You can also follow me at AK Brown Studios. That's my studio brand. Hot Press PR. So that's HAUTE Press PR. And then LA 1962 on Instagram. You're probably not going to see anything yet, but we're... like I said, slowly but surely, you're going to start producing content for that.
Okay, y'all.
Yes.
Clap it up.
Thank
you. Thank
you. Thank
you. Man, look, y'all. We're getting towards the end of the episode, man. We're about to end this thing. I'm going to end it out with another old school song and then the outro. I appreciate y'all ashy asses being here. As
long oh, this is my shit. Did. I knew he was going to play it because I remember I said, who dick you sucking? I knew it. I knew you was going to play it.
What?
Guys going down.
Yeah, that's my shit.
Who dick you sucking? Yeah, I felt the energy.
Shit.
Oh,
that's
well.
My shit. So look, y'all make sure y'all tune in
yes.
next week. We got the homeboy, my nigga, DC, media personality, DC, a.k.a. the problem child.
Okay.
Lincoln, y'all, he out in the Maryland area on 93.9 WKYS. And then we got a brother, he's going to be calling in for his part. Then we got a brother coming in, he's a poet. His name is Ibenegod.
Fucks with him, Reese, on me.
So y'all make sure you rock with your boy. It's your boy, Nico the Great. Then we got one half of the co-host tandem.
You heard me, your girl, yeah, y'all a flirt.
And we out this thing.
Okay. Ibenegod coming, Reese, that's one of my best friends, homeboy.
What type of games being played? How's it going down? It's all to the score that I got to know now. Is you with me or what? Think I'm trying to give me a nut. Cause honey's wanna give me the vibe. Why?
I'm politicking with the chicken, wondering if I'm a creeper. Little hood rapping from 25th named Jamaica. Coming through like I do, you know, getting my bark on. Knew she was a thug.
love, cause when I met her, she had a scarf on. 5411, size 7 in girls. Baby face would look like she was 11 with curls. Girlfriend, what? Remember me from way back? I'm the same cap, the wave cap that my fucker at TNT used to blaze at. Still here, so it's all good. Oh, you know my niggas rich and them doing their thing on 35th Dan. It's a small hood and it's all wood, so let me get that number. I get up,
alright.
Hit you on the track later on, see what's up. Talking to Shorty made me wanna do something nice. What? Looking at that ass made me wanna do something tonight. What? And I know right when I see right. Shorty looking like she tight and she bite. Let her give a nigga the green light.
With them hands are being played, how's it going down? It's on till it's gone, then I got to know now.
What you need, what you want, want for nothing, cause I got you, but you front, I see you with your baby father, but it don't matter, since you gave me the pussy, that ass getting fatter, let that nigga play daddy, make moves with me, I done kept it more than real, boo, can't lose with me,
true,
dirty smacked you, cause you said my name while y'all was sexy, ran up on this cat, he thought was me, and started flexing, you know I ain't even with that. He gon' have to get that just on GP. Tried to creep me? What? Leave that nigga sleepy. Put on the strength for you, when that show kids daddy. I ain't gon' send him on his way, put him up in that big caddy. But let him know. Never mind, yo, I need you to go. Take the snow up to 150, see Joe. Get that, come back with that, and we can split that. Sit back, fuck, fuck for L, get that.
Whatever games are being played, how's it going down? It's on till it's gone, then I got to know now.
Respect is not expected, but it's given cause it's real. Being neglected's a norm, expected, you deal. Lie, cheat, and steal for me. Put something in the nigga's wig if you spill for me. Kill for me, you still with me? Cause we get down like what? Told you from the door, it ain't all about a nut. I'm gonna be fed, trying to be there, we gonna see that. Hit me with the question, boo, that answer gonna be yeah. Right. See there, something can go wrong, it does. Loved it, let it go, when it came back, that's how strong it was. But you belong to cuss, couldn't belong to me. It was wrong for me, but we gon' always be best of friends.
Ha ha,
bad love, boo, to the end.
What time is it?
Love song.